really special.
You want to get somebody out with them.
All these candidates, just for you.
Me?
I'm Shauna.
I heard about it.
I'm Charter Review Board.
Oh, are you?
Yes.
Yeah, everybody said that was really easy.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah, they said they were meeting at UTC as well.
Long, Shauna. What are they replacing the entire?
There's five positions open.
Yeah, I know. Looks like the whole board. How many are on the board?
Ten.
Which one are you running for?
Charter Review District Four.
Oh, you mean when it opened?
But all of Sarasota County goes to the districts of the Charter Review.
Democrat, oh my goodness. I thought they were endangered species in Sarasota County.
We're trying to make some back.
Are you hearing the voice?
Why in the world would they do that? And they did that.
Six.
Fascinating why they're not more of a balance.
Yes, there are 10 Republicans on the Charter Review.
Cabinet and honorary.
Correct.
So that was just.
Four Democrats running and one, no party affiliate running.
They diverted the traffic.
So hopefully we'll get a little more balance.
I go through Bill and, or University and I-75 every day.
Yeah, but that's what they did. If you went up on Fruitville that day, they put signs out there that said for grand opening, UTC Mall, use Fruitville exit.
You're hearing it?
And they put them from Fruitville and back around this way, the detour signs.
For here? Oh, there you go. Okay. You can hear that all right?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I think they did a good job on Kettering Road.
You know, everybody, a lot of people like me. I think they did a good job on that demolition part.
Yeah, we'll see how she uses it.
I think we really needed something like that.
Yeah, we'll see how it gets used, you know. We'll see. We'll know at the end.
In a few years, when they can't put it in, and the tour is not here.
Well, that's what happened. Does anybody have any time constraints?
That's what happened.
We'll just go. What do you have questions? It's all ready that you're going to ask?
Yes, sir.
All right, well, let's.
Do you want a certain?
Well, I can sit here where you want.
How do you want to do it?
You need to be, since the camera's there, you need to face the camera when you get asked questions, so. Nobody has to leave by three or anything like that.
Steve Riley, Englewood.
Oh, hi, Steve Riley. Alexandra Coe.
Or you can be up here.
Nice to meet you.
Since you're all milling up here.
County Commission. Oh.
Okay, I usually cover Charlotte County.
Oh, do you?
Both sides of the street.
Yeah, isn't that true? I know, I have a lot in Englewood, Charlotte County. That's why I like Englewood.
Yeah, we should kind of, I think the, them kind of celebrate.
You want to put us together, put the Charter Review girls there and put us to it?
I thought I'd introduce myself. I'm John.
John, what are you running for?
I'm running for Sarasota County Commissioner.
And Ken Marcus said he would come.
Ken said he's coming, isn't he?
He did say he's coming, but he's not here yet.
Steve Riley.
I presume show up. If he's, you know, if he comes, we've got everybody, except any members of the
Party of Affiliation.
That's most likely.
There you are.
Well, you know, you know where everybody else is. They got that open house for more matters.
Oh, well, of course.
I debate the artists.
Yeah, well, they don't even invite me to those things.
Well, I'm a good one.
Are you?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, grab a seat. All right, everybody. Welcome to the first annual Englewood Candidates Forum at Elsie Ford Library. My name is Gerald Duesberg. I'm interested in these forums because I think local races are probably a lot more important than most people think they are. They may be the most important races of all. Probably people on the county commission and the charter review board and the school board have more impact on the average individual's life than, say, the governor does or the attorney general, or for sure the members of Congress. Okay, so we have here for county commission and two for the charter review board, and perhaps one for the school board will be coming. So I'm gonna just start with District Two. And we have Alexandra Cole and Pete Thiessen here. So I'm gonna ask them questions first. I'm gonna ask first, do I have any preference? You know, when you want to go first?
Mr. Minder is in the.
Yeah, he's in four.
I'm doing four.
We're doing two first. So you don't, I can just pick?
You can just pick.
Well, we'll do it alphabetically then. Alex? Okay, so my first question, Alex, is why did you choose to run for the Sarasota County Commission position?
Well, I chose to run for Sarasota County Commission position because my experiences being both a citizen and being involved on a variety of different levels with government, I have seen that the voice of the people is not being heard and not being applied to policy. And so I wanted to come to be that person that will actually listen to the people.
Okay. My second question is, and this is somewhat problematical in that you're not elected yet, you haven't served before, so you don't necessarily have any proposals, but do you have any proposals in mind right now to be considered in the future by the county commission? If you don't have
I have a number of proposals that probably better for people just to go to my website at www.alexandracoe.com. But one of the things that the people in Englewood are probably most interested in is issues of infrastructure. Those are big issues for Englewood. And also new ways to revitalize the downtown area. It's such a charming downtown on Dearborn Street, but a lot of people would like to see a little bit more commercial businesses and something there that would revitalize it and give it some more economic oomph. And I think that that's definitely something that could be done.
Third question is, where did you grow up? And how did you get to Sarasota County?
I grew up in Ohio, the west side of Cleveland. And like many people in Florida, I ran away from the snow. And I've lived in Florida for 30 years and came to Sarasota 20 years ago to raise my family.
Last question for right now is, what life experiences and or character traits do you have that will help you perform well in this position if you're elected to the county commission?
Well, I think I have a lot of life experience and business experience that help me to function very well in a government position. One of the biggest things that I think I bring is that I'm a bridge builder. I'm always looking for the win-win in situations and how you can address the needs of the most people while causing the least amount of harm, preferably no harm to people in government. And I also think that my experience as an anthropologist keeps me focused on people and understanding that people usually have the best ideas for how to solve problems, better ideas than government, I think.
Thank you. That's the first round of questioning for you. Now I'm going to go on to Mr. Thiessen. Why did you choose to run for the Sarasota County County Commissioner position?
I've been running for office for 5 years. My website has been up for 5 years. You can read any article you want on there. I've left them all up. If you just type in elect-Pete into Google, you'll probably get it in the first one. If you have to write in my last name, T-H-E-I-S-E-N. You separate all three with dashes, and that will certainly get you there. Now, I decided to run back when I started to run because I saw that the county commission and the city commission was doing not just a bad job, but a corrupt job. If you have a big business, they favor you, and they put taxpayer money into your pocket. But if you've got a small business, they burden you with regulations and laws and all kinds of things and just try to drive you out. So I started running because I saw government doing terrible things when they should be doing good things.
Okay. Again, do you have any proposals in mind right now to be considered by the county commission should you be elected? If you don't, that's fine. You're not in a position yet, but maybe you have some ideas.
Well, generally speaking, the proposals come from staff, but I would like to float a few ideas if anyone would ever listen. I see we have a member of the press there. I might even email it to him if he gives me my email address. But I'd like to see that we started using a smaller footprint for our new development and going up rather than spreading out like an octopus. We've only got so much land, which was, as pointed out by Steve McAllister, who dropped out of the race. And once it's gone, it's gone. But we aren't the only ones using the land. There is also plants and animals. These things need a little bit of land, although it's true that we can truck in anything we want. We could have a good business here growing and caring for animals as well. So I would propose that we went up instead of out. That's just to begin with. The second one is, I noticed the other day that the Lido Association was having an ongoing problem with getting their beach renourished, and in talking to them, they just recently formed a special tax district. So now they're accumulating money to fund their needs, which is something that could be done on new development to fund infrastructure if the developers just can't possibly pay it themselves. They could form a special district, and then at least it would be paid for by the new people rather than the taxpayers as a whole. Want any more?
No, that'll be good.
Okay, I've got plenty more.
You'll have an opportunity later, should you wish to elucidate. Okay.
Yes.
Mr. Thiessen, where did you grow up and how did you get to Sarasota County?
I grew up in the ghetto. There's a town in that, well, there used to be a town in Michigan called Detroit. It's pretty much going back to farmland now. But once upon a time, Detroit was a big place, and I lived there, and I walked down the streets, and sometimes I got beat up, but not every day, and they didn't kill me, so, I mean, the people who beat me up. Anyway, that's where I grew up. Anyone ever heard of Detroit? Yeah, some people have heard of it. Okay, that's where I grew up.
And how did you get to Sarasota County?
Well, I was running the body shop business. I had had several locations. And in 1979, everything went bust. Most of you are too young to remember 1979, but I remember it. Everything went bust, and I didn't have any more business, and finally I had to close. And the lawyer said that I lost, how much did he say? $960,000. That's how much the lawyer said I lost. I said, well, gee, I'm just as broke if I'd have lost 10 bucks as losing 970, or whatever it was. So anyway, I lost all that money, and some of it wasn't my own money. Everybody in the world wanted to break my kneecaps. So I came to Sarasota, having spent my final days in Detroit working part-time cleaning toilets. When I got to Sarasota, I managed to get a full-time job cleaning toilets. So that's how I came to Sarasota.
Okay, well that will kind of...
Yeah, that's a smelly one, isn't it?
Yeah, that will kind of merge right into this last question. What life experiences and or character traits do you have that will help you perform well in this position of county commissioner?
Well, I'm not afraid to get my hands dirty. I have had any kind of a life experience that you might want to have except giving birth. And there's just about everything that anyone could do, I've had to do, going from job to job, working from temp agencies. I've worked for 60 years. I've worked in the field picking agricultural products, and I've worked in a clinic being a doctor. I've done it all. And, you know, oh wait, I've never been a registered professional engineer. However, I have been a cut and dry engineer because I couldn't afford a registered professional engineer, and I did manage to finish the project.
Good for you. Okay, that finishes the first round for you. Now, going on to District 4, we have John Minder. So let me start with you, our registered professional engineer. Why did you choose to run for the Sarasota County Commission position?
Well, good afternoon, everyone. I decided to run for the Sarasota County Commission because I'm a registered professional engineer, I'm a registered professional surveyor and mapper, and I'm the president and owner of Minder and Associates Engineering Corporation. I have lived in Sarasota County for the past 33 years, and I have been a participant in the government, although not at the elected official position, and have served on numerous committees, and have sent numerous emails to the county commissioners on things that I think need to be done, and they met on deaf ears, and I decided if I'm ever going to be able to make an impact on Sarasota County, I'm going to have to get elected as Sarasota County Commissioner and see if I can convince two other people on the Board of County Commissioners that some of the ideas I have merit. And I have 51 years as a registered professional engineer, and I have 61 years as a registered professional surveyor and mapper, and I know Sarasota County like the back of my hand.
Okay. Do you have any proposals in mind right now to be considered by the county commission should you be elected?
Yes, I do. I am totally opposed to the 2050 plan with its fiscal neutrality. And I have proposed to Sarasota County that for the area east of the interstate that they look at a total community plan and prepare a master plan for utilities and for roads, and that they adjust the impact fees accordingly. And I think that the 2050 plan with fiscal neutrality has been an economic disaster in Sarasota County. And we've had negative revenues in Sarasota County for the past 8 years. And we've drawn down the surpluses where there's no surplus left in Sarasota County. And unless something is done with the 2050 plan with its fiscal neutrality, I see increase in salaries every year from now on, as long as the 2050 plan is in place. I have also been involved in the homeless problem in Sarasota County, and I think that the homeless have created a problem for all of the businesses because the homeless are all located in the downtown areas of our cities in Sarasota, as well as spread out throughout the county. And I have recommended to the Sarasota County Board of County Commissioners that they consider the Bob Building, which is a county-owned building. It's located 8.5 miles from downtown city of Sarasota. It's 133,000 square feet, located on 24.9 acres. And that facility should be run by the Sarasota County Health Department, which has the expertise to provide the help that the homeless with their addictions and just plain homelessness and counseling and stuff to make them productive citizens in the Sarasota County. I have recommended there's 389 employees in the Sarasota County owned Bob Building at the present time. And I have recommended that they be moved to the downtown city of Sarasota, where they'll be productive workers, and to remove the homeless from the downtown city of Sarasota to bring businesses back to downtown Sarasota. They're like all most cities that have this problem. They have a lot of vacancies now as businesses are moving out. And to me, it's just a common sense approach.
Okay. Next question, where did you grow up and how, I know that you just mentioned you've been in Sarasota County for 33 years, but where did you grow up and how did you get to Sarasota County?
I grew up in a small town in central Illinois, and I worked 4 years for a consulting engineering and land surveying firm after I graduated from high school. I was then in the United States Army for 2 years, and then I attended the University of Illinois, and I have a Bachelor of Science degree in civil engineering from the University of Illinois. I have also done graduate work in environmental engineering at the Illinois Institute of Technology. After I graduated from University of Illinois, I returned to Springfield, Illinois, in the firm that I had started out with, and I worked for them for 4 years, and then I went to work for City Water, Light, and Power Department in the city of Springfield, Illinois, and then I was in Cleveland as the Chief Civil Engineer for the Department of Public Utilities. And then I was in I went back to Illinois to build a total new university on a 750-acre campus in the south.